Installation of a clutch kit can be quite intimidating. As you can see, there's lots of tools and parts that go along with it. I'm going to show you step by step how to install the Dynojet Clutch Kit in this Polaris XP Turbo. Let's go over some of the tools that we're going to need during this installation. First, you're going to need the Dynojet Clutch Spring Compressor, the Dynojet Clutch Removal Tool, a torque wrench that has a range from 45 to 95 foot-pounds, a breaker bar, some various sockets and Torx bits, a 3/8 and quarter inch ratchet, and you can use some electric hand tools if it makes your life a bit easier. The first step in this process is to remove the fresh air duct to the clutch. You're gonna wanna remove the spring guard and of course, the clutch cover. Now that you have the screws removed from the clutch cover, you can go ahead and pull it off. It's easiest if you pull it off and go down with it to get it out of the car. Now it's time to remove the belt. You can use the supplied belt removal tool that comes with the car when you purchased it, or you can use a separate tool that might work a little bit easier for you. We always have these belts on and off, so we made something up ourselves that works a little easier. Okay. Now we're just going to remove the belt. Remove it from the primary and the secondary. We're not going to need it on there right now. Go ahead and remove the tool. Now it's time to remove the bolts that hold the primary and the secondary clutches into place. Now it's not recommended that you use an impact to remove these bolts, so you're going to need something that'll give you a little bit of leverage on your clutches to break them free. Now we've already broken these bolts free, so we can go ahead and remove them by hand. We're going to go ahead and start with the secondary. Remove this bolt. Make sure the bolt and the washers come off together so you don't lose any of them. And now we'll remove the primaries. Now that the bolts have been removed, we can go ahead and pull the secondary clutch right off and just set it off to the side for now. Now we're going to install the clutch removal tool. Thread it in until it stops. Now you're going to take a 1-inch socket with a breaker bar and you're going to go ahead and break the primary clutch free. There we go. Just remove the clutch removal tool and pull the primary off. Now that the primary and the secondary clutch has been removed, it's time for us to remove the springs using the Dynojet Clutch Spring Compressor. With the Dynojet Clutch Spring Compressor completely disassembled, you're going to take your primary and you're going to slide it right over the shaft, all the way through. Take this cup, set it on top, this smaller cup with this little gasket right on top. Take the arm and just start cranking down. It'll go ahead and relieve the tension off the spring so we can remove this spider on the top. Remove all six of these bolts. Set them off to the side. You'll relieve the spring pressure by going counterclockwise on the tool. Now that the spring pressure has been removed, go ahead and remove the top piece. Make sure this black plastic disc stays with these parts because it's going to go right back in. Remove your OEM spring, set it off to the side. And now this is a good time for you to go ahead and take a look at some of these wear items. Now this is a brand new clutch, so these items haven't been damaged yet, but in most cases, these little guides will be damaged as well as these supports that are around it. So if any of these pieces are damaged, go ahead and replace them at this time. I'm going to go ahead and remove the clutch arms now by using an 1/8-inch Allen key and a 10mm socket. The easiest thing to do here is take the magnets that come in your kit, stick them to your arm, remove the pin, and you can slide the arm right out. You're going to repeat this step for the next two arms. Now that the OEM arms have been removed from the clutch, it's time to replace them with one of the Dynojet arms. Now these arms have magnets in them, so you have the ability to adjust the weight for whatever RPM you need the vehicle to run at, depending on tire size and power level. The standard settings is going to be a 1, 3, and a 2 setting. Now you could fill this completely up with weight if your car makes a lot of power, or if it doesn't make much power, you can remove weight as well. I'm going to show you how to load these weights. And we do that simply by taking the magnets that are supplied in the kit, putting them into the holes. Make sure the polarity of the magnets are going in the same direction. If not, the magnets will not stick to each other and they could come out of the arm. Now that we have the weight installed under the arm, we're going to go ahead and put them back into the clutch. The Dynojet Clutch Kit comes with three different springs, two primary springs, and a secondary spring. The primary spring we're going to use in this particular combination is going to be the red one. The red one's great for tire combinations up to 32 inches, as well as vehicles that make a little bit more power. Since we're going to flash this car with the Power Vision 3 and up the boost, we're going to go ahead and use the red spring. The yellow spring is good if you're going to go ahead and put paddle tires on the vehicle and take it out to the dunes. You're going to take the red spring, you're going to slide it right over the top. You're going to take the black disc, slide it over the spring, and then you're going to take the pressure plate and put it right on top. From here, you're going to use your clutch compression tool and put it all back together. Reinstall the bolts the way they came out and tighten everything up. Now that all the bolts have been reinstalled and tightened up, you can go ahead and remove the primary clutch from the clutch spring compressor. Now that the primary clutch is done, it's time for us to start on the secondary. We're going to go ahead and install this on the clutch spring compressor so we can get the springs out of it and replace it with the new green spring. But first, the cup that went on top of the primary slides down onto the spring compressor first. Then we take this secondary clutch, slide it right over. Just make sure the recess in the bottom of this tool goes into that spot evenly. And complete the assembly. From here, using a T30 Torx, you're going to remove these three screws. Now these are Loctited in. In some cases, they're too tight for you to get out by hand, so you might have to use a torch to heat them up. We'll go ahead and loosen up the clutch spring compressor. Now you can go ahead and pull out the secondary spring. This is also a good time to take a look at the ramps that are in the secondary clutch. If these look damaged, worn out, this is probably a good time for you to go ahead and replace them. You're going to go ahead and take the new Dynojet secondary spring, slide it in place, put the disc back on top, and you'll reassemble in the reverse order that you pulled it apart from. Reinstall the clutch spring compressor tool, tighten everything down. Once everything's lined up, go ahead and reinstall the screws. Before reinstalling the screws, just add a little bit of Loctite to them. This just ensures that they won't fall out of the secondary after installation. Now that's it for the installation of the secondary spring. Go ahead and remove the clutch from the clutch spring compressor, and you're gonna reinstall it on the car. We're gonna go ahead and reinstall the primary clutch now. We'll get it in here. Get its bolt started. Now the primary clutch has to be torqued down to 95 foot-pounds. So you're gonna need something in here to give it a little bit of leverage while you torque it down. We have a specialty tool here called a torque stick. Slide it on in. Just pry it on in there. It just gives you enough force against it so you can actually torque it down. Set your torque wrench to 95 foot-pounds. When installing the secondary clutch, you're going to want to make sure the car is in gear. That just keeps this input shaft from turning while we're trying to install this. In reverse order, just make sure you put the washer back in place and this sleeve back in place. Bolt in, and you're going to tighten this one down to 45 foot-pounds. From here, you can go ahead and put the car back into park so the secondary is free to spin. We're gonna reinstall the belt removal tool. And now, we're gonna reinstall the belt. Make sure you reinstall the belt in the same exact fashion that you removed it. Now that the belt is installed, we're gonna go ahead and remove the belt removal tool. Now that the belt removal tool has been removed, just go ahead and give the secondary a few spins until the belt is nice and riding at the top of the secondary. Now that the primary and secondary clutch are reinstalled on the car, we're ready to put the clutch cover back on it with the fresh air tube and go rip this thing around. For more information or a list of available vehicles that we have clutches for, go to dynojet.com.